This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Javanese DVNZ Bahasa Jawa IPA 22 consonants 3 morphology 4 syntax 5 vocabulary 6 registers 7 dialects of modern Javanese 71 phonetic differences 72 vocabulary differences 73 classification 8 history 81 old Javanese 82 middle Javanese 83 new Javanese 84 modern Javanese 9 Javanese script 10 demographic distribution of Javanese speakers 11 Javanese today 12 basic vocabulary 13 numbers 14 see also 15 notes 16 sources 17 further reading 18 external links speakers the word Jawa Java written in Javanese script the language is spoken in Central and East Java, as well as on the north coast of West Java it is also spoken elsewhere by the Javanese people in other provinces of Indonesia, which are numerous due to the government-sanctioned transmigration program in the late 20th century, including Lampung, Jambi, and North Sumatra provinces in Suriname, Creolized Javanese is spoken among descendants of plantation migrants brought by the Dutch during the 19th century in Madura, Bali, Lombok, and the Sunda region of West Java. It is also used as a literary language. It was the court language in Palembang, South Sumatra, until the palace was sacked by the Dutch in the late 18th century. Javanese is written with the Latin script, Javanese script, and Arabic script in the present day. The Latin script dominates writings, although the Javanese script is still taught. As part of the compulsory Javanese language subject in elementary up to high school levels in Central and East Java, Javanese is the 10th largest language by native speakers and the largest language without official status. It is spoken or understood by approximately 100 million people. At least 45% of the total population of Indonesia are of Javanese descent or live in an area where Javanese is the dominant language. All 7 Indonesian presidents since 1945 have been of Javanese descent. It is therefore not surprising that Javanese has had a deep influence on the development of Indonesian, the national language of Indonesia. There are 3 main dialects of the modern language, Central Javanese, Eastern Javanese, and Western Javanese. There is a dialect continuum from Banten in the extreme west of Java to Banyuwangi Regency in the eastern corner of the island. All Javanese dialects are more or less mutually intelligible. Phonology. The phonemes of modern standard Javanese as shown below. Vowels front central back. Closed I. Otherwise they are, or identical, ee, u, in the standard dialect of Surakarta, a, is pronounced in word final open syllables, and in any open penultimate syllable before such in consonants labial dental, alveolar retroflex palatal velar glottal nasal m, stop, affricate p. b, td, tdk, fricative, h approximant lateral jw, Rhotic, the Javanese voiced phonemes are not in fact voiced but voiceless, with breathy voice on the following vowel. The relevant distinction in phonation of the plosives is described as stiff voice versus slack voice. A Javanese syllable can have the following form, CSVC, where C. Syntax. Modern Javanese usually employs SVO word order, however, Old Javanese sometimes had VSO and sometimes VOS word order. Even in modern Javanese, archaic sentences using VSO structure can still be made. Examples, Modern Javanese, Dewake S Tika V Ing PP Keratin O, Old Javanese, Tika V Ta Part Sira S Re PP Ing Def Art Kadatwan O. Both sentences mean, he S comes V into PP the Def Art Palace O. In the old Javanese sentence, the verb is placed at the beginning and is separated by the particle ta from the rest of the sentence. In modern Javanese, the definite article is lost, and definiteness is expressed by other means. If necessary, verbs are not inflected for person or number. There is no grammatical tense. Time is expressed by auxiliary words meaning yesterday, already, etc. There is a complex system of verb affixes to express differences of status in subject and object. However, in general, the structure of Javanese sentences, both old and modern, can be described using the topic-comment model, without having to refer to conventional grammatical categories. The topic is the head of the sentence, the comment is the modifier, so the example sentence has a simpler description, Dewake. Vocabulary. Javanese has a rich and varied vocabulary, with many loanwords supplementing those from the native Austronesian base. Sanskrit has had a deep and lasting impact. The Old Javanese English Dictionary contains approximately 25,500 entries, over 12,600 of which are borrowings from Sanskrit. Such a high number is no measure of usage, but it does suggest the extent to which the language adopted Sanskrit words for formal purposes. In a typical Old Javanese literary work, about 25% of the vocabulary is from Sanskrit. Many Javanese personal names also have clearly recognizable Sanskrit roots. Sanskrit words are still very much in use. Modern speakers may describe Old Javanese and Sanskrit words as Kawi, roughly meaning literary, but Kawi words may also be from Arabic. Dutch and Malay are influential as well, but none of these rivals the position of Sanskrit. There are far fewer Arabic loanwords in Javanese than in Malay, and they are usually concerned with Islamic religion. Nevertheless, some words have entered the basic vocabulary, such as pakir, to think, from the Arabic fikr, badin, body, maripat, eye, thought to be derived from the Arabic marifa, meaning knowledge or vision. However, these Arabic words typically have native Austronesian or Sanskrit alternatives, pakir. Sanskrit Dutch loanwords usually have the same form and meaning as in Indonesian, with a few exceptions. Javanese Indonesian Dutch English pit sepeda fiets bicycle pit montor sepeda motor motor fiets motorcycle sepor karita api spoor, i.e. rail track. Train. The word sepor also exists in Indonesian, but there it has preserved the literal Dutch meaning of railway tracks, while the Javanese word follows Dutch figurative use, and spoor lit rail is used as metonymy for train lit train. Compare. A similar metonymic use in English, to travel by rail, may be used for to travel by train. Malay was the lingua franca of the Indonesian archipelago before the proclamation of Indonesian independence in 1945, and Indonesian, which was based on Malay, is now the official language of Indonesia. As a consequence, there has been an influx of Malay and Indonesian vocabulary into Javanese. Many of these words are concerned with bureaucracy or politics. Registers. A Javanese noble lady left would address her servant with one vocabulary, and be answered with another. Studio portrait of painter Raden Saleh's wife and a servant, Colonial Batavia, 1860-1872. In common with other Austronesian languages, Javanese is spoken differently depending on the social context. In Austronesian there are often three distinct styles or registers. Each employs its own vocabulary, grammatical rules, and even prosody. In Javanese these styles are called ngoko, informal speech, used between friends and close relatives. It is also used by persons of higher status such as elders, or bosses addressing those of lower status young people, or subordinates in the workplace. Madya, intermediate between Ngoko and Krama. Strangers on the street would use it, where status differences may be unknown and one wants to be neither too formal nor too informal. The term is from Sanskrit Madya, middle, Krama, the polite and formal style. It is used between those of the same status when they do not wish to be informal. It is used by persons of lower status to persons of higher status, such as young people to their elders, or subordinates to bosses, and it is the official style for public speeches, announcements, etc. The term is from Sanskrit krama, in order. There are also metastyle, honorific words, and their converse, humilifics. Speakers use humble words concerning themselves, but honorific words concerning anyone of greater age of higher social status. The humilific words are called krama andhap, while the honorifics are called krama ingle. Children typically use the ngoko style, but in talking to the parents they must be competent with both krama ingle and krama andhap. Some examples: ngoko, aku arep mangan, I want to eat, madya, kula ayeng neta krama. Neutral. Kula bade nadi humble dalem bade nedi. The most polite word meaning eat is dahar, but it is forbidden to use these most polite words for oneself, except when talking with someone of lower status, and in this case, Ngoko style is used. Such most polite words are reserved for addressing people of higher status. Mixed usages. Honorific, addressing someone of high status. Bipak kura dahar, do you want to eat, literally, does father want to eat, reply to a person of lower status, expressing speaker's superiority. Iya, aku kura dahar, yes, I want to eat, reply to a person of lower status, but without expressing superiority. Iya, aku arep mangan, reply to a person of equal status. Inga, kula bade neta. The use of these different styles is complicated and requires thorough knowledge of Javanese culture, which adds to the difficulty of Javanese for foreigners. The full system is not usually mastered by most Javanese themselves, who might use only the Ngoko and a rudimentary form of the Krama. People who can correctly use the different styles are held in high esteem. Dialects of modern Javanese. Susuhunan Pakubuano X of Surakarta. Surakarta has been a center of Javanese culture, and its dialect is regarded as the most refined. There are three main groups of Javanese dialects, based on sub-regions: Western Javanese, Central Javanese, and Eastern Javanese. The differences are primarily in pronunciation, but with vocabulary differences also. Javanese dialects are all mutually intelligible. Central Javanese Jawa Tengahan is founded on the speech of Surakarta and to a lesser extent of Yogyakarta. It is considered the most refined of the regional variants, and serves as a model for the standard language. Those two cities are the seats of four Javanese principalities, heirs to the Mataram Sultanate that once dominated the whole of Java and beyond. This variant is used throughout Central Java and special region of Yogyakarta, and there are many lower-level dialects such as Maria and Semarangan, as well as Surakarta and Yogyakarta themselves. The variations in Central Java are said to be so plentiful that almost every administrative region or kabupaten has its own local slang, but those minor dialects are not seen as distinct by most Javanese speakers. Central Javanese is also used in the western part of East Java province. For example, Javanese spoken in the Madian region along with Javanese spoken in Blitar, Ponorogo, Pasitan, and Tulungagung, and central parts of Kediri bears a strong influence of Surakarta. Javanese Mataraman dialect, standard dialect, is spoken commonly in Yogyakarta. Surakarta, Clayton, Karanganyar, Wanogiri, Sukaharyo, and Bayolali Pakalongan dialect is spoken in Pakalongan and Pakalongan Regency, and also in Pemalong. Kedu dialect is spoken in the former Kedu Residency, including Temanggung, Kabuman, Magaling, and Wonosobo. Bagalan dialect is spoken in Purworejo. Semarang dialect is spoken in Semarang, Semarang Regency, and also Salatiga, Damak, and Kendal. Eastern North Coast dialect, or dialect Maria, is spoken in Japara, Rembang, Kudus, Pati, and also in Tuban and Bahonagoro. Blora dialect is spoken in Blora, the eastern part of Grobogan, and the western part of Nawi. Madianan dialect is spoken mainly in western part of East Java province, including Madian, Blitar, Nawi, Pasitan, Ponorogo, and Majitan. Western Javanese Jawa Kalonan, spoken in the western part of the Central Java province and throughout the West Java province, particularly on the north coast, includes dialects that are distinct for their Sundanese influences. It retains many archaic words. North Bantan dialect Jawa Serang is spoken in Serang, Selegan, and the western part of Tangerang Regency. Serban dialect Serebonan or Basa Serbon is spoken in Serban, and Losari Indramayu dialect or Dermayan, which is spoken in Indramayu, Karawang, and Subang, is sometimes included in Serebonan. Tigal dialect, known as Tigalan or dialect Pantara. North Coast dialect, is spoken in Tigal, Brebes, and the western part of Pemalong Regency. Banyumas dialect, known as Banyumasan, is spoken in Banyumas, Silakap, Purbalingga, Banjarnagara, and Bumiayu. These western Javanese dialects are sometimes referred to as Basa Napak Apak by other Javanese. Eastern Javanese Jawa Wetanan speakers range from the eastern banks of Brantas River in Kertosono, and from Nanyuk to Banyuwangi, comprising the majority of the East Java province excluding Madura Island. However, the variant has been influenced by Madurese, and is sometimes referred to as Surabayan speech. The most outlying Eastern Javanese dialect is spoken in Balambangan or Banyuwangi. It is generally known as Basa Osing Osing, a local negation word, is a cognate of Tusing in Balinese. Arikan dialect is commonly spoken in Surabaya, Malang, Gresik, Mojokerto, Pasuruan, Lumajang, Lamongan, and Sidoryo. Many Madurese people also use this dialect as their second language. Jombing dialect, Tengger dialect used by Tenggerese people, which is centered in 30 villages in the isolated Tengger Mountains. Mount Bromo within the Bromo Tengger Semeru National Park in East Central Java. Osing dialect spoken in Banyuwangi. Surinamese Javanese is mainly based on Central Javanese, especially from the Kedu Residency. The number of speakers of Suriname Javanese in Suriname is estimated at 60002012. Most Surinamese Javanese are bi or trilingual according to the 2004 census. Surinamese Javanese was the first or second language in 11% of households in a 2012 study of multilingualism in Surinamese education by the Dutch Language Union. 3,497 out of 22,643 15% pupils in primary education indicated Surinamese Javanese as a language spoken at home. Most of them were living in the Wanaka and Paramaribo districts. Not all immigrants from Indonesia to Suriname were speakers of Javanese. Immigration records show that 90% of immigrants were Javanese, with 5% Sundanese, 0.5% Madurese, and 2.5% from Batavia. The ethnic composition of this last group was not determinable. Probably Sundanese, Madurese, or Malay-speaking immigrants were forced to learn Javanese during their stay in Suriname to adapt in view of the language policies in Netherlands Indies at the time of immigration. It is unlikely the immigrants had knowledge of the Dutch language prior to immigration to Suriname. Dutch today is the official language of Suriname. Surinamese Javanese is somewhat different from Indonesian Javanese. In Surinamese Javanese there is a difference between formal and informal speech. Surinamese Javanese took many loanwords from languages like Dutch, Surinantango, Sarnami and Bahasa Indonesia. The influence of the latter language, which is not spoken in Suriname, can be attributed to the Indonesian embassy and Islamic teachers from Indonesia. Indonesian movies are popular, and usually shown without subtitles on Surinamese Javanese television channels. Surinamese Javanese Surinantango Dutch English Ngebra Abra over across Bakra. Bakra blank white man blankman blackman neger black man pernongsi pernasi plantage plantation sekot skautu shout polita agent policeman. In 1986, the Surinamese government adopted an official spelling for Surinamese Javanese. It is seldom used as a written language. However, in the 2012 survey, pupils who indicated Surinamese Javanese as a language spoken at home reported Dutch 97.9% and Surinantango 76.9% also being spoken in the household. Surinamese Javanese speaking pupils report high proficiency in speaking and understanding, but very low literacy in the language. They report a low preference for the language in interaction with family members, including their parents, with the exception of their grandparents. Pupils where Surinamese Javanese is spoken at tend at home to speak Dutch 77% rather than Surinamese Javanese 12%. Phonetic differences. Phoneme, I, at closed ultima is pronounced as in Central Javanese Surakarta-Yogyakarta dialect, as in Western Javanese Banyumasan dialect, and as in Eastern Javanese. Phoneme, U, at closed ultima is pronounced as in Central Javanese, as in Western Javanese, and as in Eastern Javanese. Phoneme, A, at closed ultima in Central Javanese is pronounced as in at open ultima. As regardless of position, it tends toward in Western Javanese and as in Eastern Javanese. Western Javanese tend to glottalize every last vowel of a word as euphony. Clarification needed, e.g., Anna Appa, what happened, Asia Kaya Ku. Don't be like that. Dialectal phonetics. Phoneme orthography. Central Javanese Standard, Western Javanese Eastern Javanese. English, I, get a blood, U, abu swollen, A, lenga oil, A, kankamu, kankane kawe. Your friend. Final consonant devoicing occurs in the standard Central Javanese dialect, but not in Banyumasan. For example, egg is pronounced in standard Central Javanese, but in Banyumasan the latter is closer to Old Javanese. Vocabulary differences. The vocabulary of standard Javanese is enriched by dialectal words. For example, to get the meaning of you, Western Javanese speakers say rika, rika, Eastern Javanese use kan, kane, or kone, kane, and Central Javanese speakers say kawe, kau. Another example is the expression of how. The Tegal dialect of Western Javanese uses kepriban, kepriban. The Banyumasan dialect of Western Javanese employs kepruwe, kepruwa, or kepruwan, kepruwan. Eastern Javanese speakers say ya, apa, jp. Pemalong. Surabaya English Aku Kita Kita, Riang, Isun, Ingsun Inyong, Niang Inyong, Niang Niang Aku I, Mikau Sire Sira Rika Kon Koa Kan. Utenan Pisan Pisan Bangat Neman, Temen Neman, Temen, Teo Temen, Taminan Truly Piye, Kepriya Kepramen Kepriban, Kepruwa Kepruwa Kepriban, Priban, Pribe Kepramen, Kepriban, Priman, Prime, Priban, Pribe Ya, Apa How Ora. Or Ora, Belly Ora Ora, Bella Ora Ora, OGA, No, not Malebu Manjing Manjing Malebu Manjing, Malebu Manjing, Malebu Malebu Enter, Come in AREP, Me AREP AREP, Pan. AREP Pan Pan, Pen, Ape, Pak AREP, Arepe, Ape be going to Saka Sake Sing Sakong Sing Kadi, Kading Tika of. From the Madian Kediri dialect has some idiosyncratic vocabulary, such as Panga, still, Standard Javanese, Panset, Lagik, Progressive Modal, Standard Javanese, Lagi, and emphatic particles NDA, Pay, and Lay classification. A preliminary general classification of Javanese dialects given by the Max Planck Institute. For Evolutionary Anthropology's Department of Linguistics is as follows. Pesisir Pemalong and Tengger are considered to be among the most conservative dialects. The Bantan, Pesisir Lor, Banyumas, Tengger, and Osing dialects do not have the vowel raising and vowel harmony features that are innovations of the standard Solo and Yogyakarta dialects. West Javanese includes Krama Andhap, Krama Ingal, Krama Halos, Madhya Registers. Bantan Serban. Central Javanese includes Krama Andhap, Krama Ingal, Krama Halos, Madhya Registers. Pesisir Lor dialects. Tegal Pemalong Pekalongan Yogyakarta Surakarta, Solo Semarang Banyumas. Silakap Purwakerto Kabuman East Javanese, includes Krama Andhap, Krama Ingal, Krama Halos, Madhya Registers Surabaya Malong Madian Kediri Nanyak Lumajang Osing Banyuwangi Tengger Nadas Ranu Pain Outer Javanese Papuan Javanese History Old Javanese. Main article, Old Javanese Language Palm Leaf Manuscript of Kakawan Sudasoma, a 14th century Javanese poem. While evidence of writing in Java dates to the Sanskrit Tarumanagara inscription of 450. The expansion of Javanese culture, including Javanese script and language, began in 1293 with the eastward push of the Hindu-Buddhist East Javanese Empire Majapahit, toward Madura and Bali. The Javanese campaign in Bali in 1363 had a deep and lasting impact, and Javanese replaced Balinese as the language of administration and literature, though the Balinese people preserved much of the older literature of Java and even created their own in Javanese idioms. Balinese ceased to be written until a 19th century restoration. See also, Kawi language Middle Javanese. The Majapahit Empire saw the rise of Middle Javanese as effectively a new language, intermediate between Old and New Javanese, though Middle Javanese is similar enough to New Javanese to be understood by anyone who is well acquainted with current literary Javanese. A New Javanese inscription in Sholaheen Mosque, Surakarta. The Majapahit Empire fell due to internal disturbances in the Paregreg Civil War, thought to have occurred in 1405 and 1406, and attacks by Islamic forces of the Sultanate of Demak on the north coast of Java. There is a Javanese chronogram concerning the fall that reads Serna Ilang Kretaning Bumi, vanished and gone was the prosperity of the world, indicating the date 1478. New Javanese in the 16th century. A new era in Javanese history began with the rise of the Islamic Central Javanese Mataram Sultanate, originally a vassal state of Majapahit. Ironically, the Mataram Empire rose as an Islamic kingdom that sought revenge for the demise of the Hindu Majapahit Empire by first crushing Demak, the first Javanese Islamic kingdom. Javanese culture spread westward as Mataram conquered many previously Sundanese areas in western parts of Java, and Javanese became the dominant language in more than a third of this area. As with Balinese, the Sundanese language ceased to be written until the 19th century. In the meantime, it was heavily influenced by Javanese, and some 40% of Sundanese vocabulary is believed to have been derived from Javanese, though Islamic in name, the Mataram. Early New Javanese documents are Islamic treatises. Later, intensive contacts with the Dutch and with other Indonesians gave rise to a simplified form of Javanese and influx of foreign loanwords. Modern Javanese, some scholars dub the spoken form of Javanese in the 20th century Modern Javanese, although it is essentially still the same language as New Javanese. Javanese script, a modern bilingual text in Portuguese and Javanese. In Yogyakarta, main article, Javanese script. Javanese has been traditionally written with Javanese script. Javanese and the related Balinese script are modern variants of the old Kawi script, a Brahmic script introduced to Java along with Hinduism and Buddhism. Kawi is first attested in a legal document from 804. Letters have subscript forms used to transcribe consonant clusters, though the shape are relatively straightforward, and not as distinct as conjunct forms of Devanagari. Some letters are only present in Old Javanese and became obsolete in Modern Javanese. Some of these letter became capital forms used in proper names. Punctuation includes a comma, period, a mark that covers the colon, quotations, and indicates numerals, and marks to introduce a chapter, poem, song, or letter. However, Javanese can also be written with the Arabic script, and today generally uses Latin script instead of Javanese script for practical purposes. A Latin orthography based on Dutch was introduced in 1926, revised in 1972-1973. It has largely supplanted the Karakan, the Latin-based forms. Majuscule forms uppercase AAABCDE. AEFGHIIJKLMNOOPQRS. TUUVWXYZ minuscule forms lowercase AAABCDEAE. FGHIIJKLMNOOPQRSTU. UVWXYZ. The letters F, Q, V, X, and Z are used in loanwords from European languages and Arabic Javanese script. Base consonant letters Ha na ka ra ka da ta.